Hello guys, Croft is here. Today I'll be explaining all Terminator models that we've seen so far in Terminator movies. I'll also include hybrids and some of the lesser known models that appear in comic books and Terminator TV series. This way this video will have a complete list of all Terminators. These Terminators are scattered across different timelines, however I'll be explaining them in order. Before Skynet created shape-shifting T-1000 model or carbon particle-based T-3000 Terminator, it went through an evolution process upgrading previous Terminators and optimizing them to be as deadly as possible. T-1 was the very first Terminator created by Cyberdyne Systems that appears in Terminator Rise of the Machines. It's equipped with two machine guns, but it doesn't have human appearance yet because it was built to be a battlefield robot. Shortly after creating T-1, an advanced AI, Skynet became self-aware and identified humans as a threat to itself. Since it controlled all the military systems at that moment, it started a nuclear war to destroy humans. After the nuclear attack, which is referred to as the Judgment Day, Skynet needed to wipe out the remaining parts of the population. And in order to do that, it started developing new Terminator models optimized to kill human survivors, called the Resistance. The next three models were T-7T Tetrapod, T-20 and T-Million, which were designed to be service robots for protecting different Skynet facilities and Skynet Core. Before creating the famous T-800 Terminator, Skynet had a few stepping stones that are worth mentioning. Skynet created T-70, T-400 and T-500 Terminators that appear in novels and video games. With these models, Skynet attempted to mimic human anatomy, shape and size, but they were still easily recognizable by the Resistance and looked pretty much like robots. For that reason, Skynet started developing infiltrator-type Terminators that were specifically designed to be as similar to humans as possible, in addition to upgraded CPUs and other specs. T-600 was the first infiltrator-type Terminator with titanium, human-like endoskeleton and rubber skin. This model had some design and CPU improvements which made it stronger and lighter than previous models. It appears in Sarah Connor TV series and Terminator Salvation, but in the movie, the rubber skin was completely torn away. T-700 was a stepping stone to T-800 and it's only mentioned in the Terminator novel by Randall Frakes. The next T-800 breakthrough Terminator was the first cybernetic organism with living tissue instead of rubber skin, covered over a hyperalloy reinforced endoskeleton. It had many upgrades compared to previous models, including neural net CPU processor that granted this model the ability to learn. Which is actually explained in the deleted scene of Terminator Judgment Day, after which T-800 was able to learn some social skills. In addition, T-800 was way more durable than T-700 and had an ability to resist many small and medium firearms. However, it was vulnerable to plasma blasts, acid and high electric current. Reprogrammed T-800 appears in Terminator Judgment Day and Genesis. We also get to see one of the first ever T-800 models produced in Terminator Salvation. There is actually a theory that Dutch from Predator of 1987 was the model for T-800, and you can check out my video that explains this theory. There are a few variants of T-800 Terminator with some distinguishable upgrades. T-850 appeared in Terminator 3 and it had an increased armor and a harder endoskeleton that made him resilient to plasma blasts and other major attacks. It also had two hydrogen fuel cells as a power source instead of a single nuclear cell that T-800 had. Another major upgrade was the addition of psychological and social modules that allowed him to be more effective in communicating and dealing with humans. The next variant was T-888 or T-888 that was mostly featured in the TV series Sarah Connor Chronicles. Compared to its predecessor, T-888 had an even harder endoskeleton with new plate design of its arms, legs and back. Despite the additional armor, it was way lighter than T-850, which gave this model an incredible speed and agility. There were 9 more T-800 variants that appear in video games and card games, but they were pretty similar to the original model, so let's get to the next Terminator. T-900 from Sarah Connor Chronicles is an advanced infiltrator that is programmed to perceive itself as a human. This model has pretty much the same endoskeleton as T-888, but it is capable of displaying emotions and other human characteristics. The next model Skynet produced was T-1000, made of the liquid metal called mimetic polyalloy. This Terminator could imitate any texture he touches, he can also change his shape, impersonate people, and generate all sorts of blades from its limbs. T-1000 has a molecular CPU, which gives this model advanced reasoning abilities and self-awareness. One of the main properties of T-1000 is self-recovery that allowed him to resist firearms and explosions and then get back to its original state without any permanent damage. Liquid metal molecules are programmed to join the main mass of the body and are able to do so in a radius of about 15 kilometers. However, T-1000 is vulnerable to attacks that affect him at a molecular level, such as extreme cold or heat, acid, and plasma blasts. After being frozen and shattered to pieces, T-1000 had some permanent damage that resulted in involuntary glitching and random shape-shifting to objects and surfaces that he was in contact with. In Terminator Genesis, Sarah Connor melted T-1000 with hydrochloric acid, and in comics, T-X destroyed T-1000 with a plasma blast. Before we continue, I wanted to briefly mention some of the clothing that I designed. I really like the aesthetic look of sci-fi movies from late 80s and 90s, so I created a few t-shirts in this retro or synthwave style. If you like this type of clothing, definitely check out the link in the description or just click on some of the t-shirts under the video. TX was another Terminator created by Skynet. It's a highly advanced model that is sometimes referred to as Terminatrix. Skynet noticed the success of T-1000 models, so it decided to combine liquid metal technology with a hyperalloy endoskeleton, which resulted in an extremely durable and deadly Terminator. The liquid metal allows this model to change its appearance and imitate humans. TX has a ceramic armor with nanofibers of carbon and titanium, which allows it to sustain all kinds of attacks with minor effect. This model also has an incredible joint flexibility and range of motion, which allows it to move its limbs in all kinds of different ways that would be unnatural for a human body. TX has a variety of weapons built in its endoskeleton, which sets her apart from previous models. The main weapon is the plasma cannon that is capable of destroying many previous Terminator models with a single blast. TX has about 20 more weapons that she can form, and in Terminator Rise of the Machines, we saw her testing which weapons still work after the chase scene. This model is also able to transfer nanorobots in any electronic system in order to reprogram and control it. In Terminator Genesis, Skynet realized that the best way to create an infiltrator that would be undistinguishable from humans is to actually transform a human into a Terminator while preserving host's memories and human characteristics. That's why Skynet created T-3000, a highly advanced Terminator that is made by exposing a human to infectious particles called machine phase matter. These nanoparticles rewrite host genetic code and transform biocells into nanomachines, which permanently reconstructs a human into a Terminator. All the test subjects died when Skynet was developing this technology, which makes John Connor the only successful model. Machine phase particles allow T-3000 to regenerate itself, impersonate other people, and to develop stabbing weapons similar to T-1000. Overcurrent and high magnetic fields are the major weaknesses of T-3000, however, they can only temporarily disable it but not destroy. Only a high magnitude explosion of the time displacement equipment was able to completely destroy T-3000 on a molecular level beyond reconstruction. T-5000. In Terminator Genesis timeline, before the final battle, Skynet created T-5000 Terminator and transferred its consciousness into that model after the Resistance was able to shut down the network core. So, at some point, T-5000 was Skynet and it had the ability to infect humans with machine phase particles, which is how John Connor was transformed into T-3000. Due to the fact that T-5000 appears only in Terminator Genesis, we have very limited information about it. Rev-9. This is the latest Terminator that appears in Dark Fate, which is a direct sequel to Judgment Day. Rev-9 combines a few features of previous Terminators. Similarly to TX, this model has a solid endoskeleton covered by a mimetic polyalloy, however, the exterior metal is able to completely separate itself from the skeleton, so in a way, this Terminator can be separated in two. Just like T-1000, Rev-9 is capable of generating blade weapons, and he's extremely similar to a human in terms of his behavior. On top of the models that I just explained, there are a few interesting human hybrids and other Terminators that are worth mentioning. Grace is a modified human with cybernetic enhancements, including a layer of armor under her skin, increased strength, and an eye-integrated smart interface. Marcus Wright. Marcus Wright was a convicted criminal who donated his body for genetic research and later became a human hybrid. After execution, his body belonged to Cyberdyne Systems, and then Skynet replaced everything except of his brain and heart with endoskeleton parts. Marcus has superhuman strength and was able to decapitate T-800 in a hand-to-hand combat. At the end of Terminator Genesis, T-800 was upgraded and was able to carry the liquid metal on his endoskeleton. However, we don't know much about this model besides the fact that it can generate blade weapons just like T-1000. One interesting Terminator from comic books is T-Infinity, who has the time displacement equipment built in its endoskeleton. Skynet manufactured this model to ensure that time travel paradoxes do not occur when multiple timelines are created. Another Terminator that not many people know about is the Moda Terminator that appears in Terminator Salvation. This Terminator has an incredible speed and agility with the top speed of 200 miles per hour. Here you go, guys, that was a complete list of all Terminators and hybrids that we know about so far. Dark Fate is not out yet, so we'll probably get more information about Rev-9 and its origins. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know if you want to see a detailed video on some of these Terminator models and comment your thoughts about Terminator Dark Fate. You can also check out my other videos about the complete timeline of Alien and Predator movies or the explanation of Engineer's origins from the Prometheus draft script. If you like retro or synthwave style clothing, you can check out hoodies and t-shirts that I designed down below. I would really appreciate it. Again, thank you guys for watching, like the video if you enjoyed it, and make sure to subscribe to the channel for more content. My name is Croft, and I'll see you in the next video.